speeches of our beloved Hazar Imam this week.
Thank you.
Sultan Mawlana.
Yes, thank you.
And I hope you will accept
it. I look forward to seeing them. I didn't know that they had come out now.
بسم الله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة.
May I begin by expressing my gratitude to all those individuals who have contributed to making possible this day and what it commemorates. The inauguration of the Centre Ismaili today symbolizes both the welcome accorded by the government of Portugal, the response of the Ismaili community to this land of harmony and opportunity, and its permanent commitment to Portugal. These new buildings and the spaces within and around them are rich in symbolism, drawing on the plurality of cultures which characterize Ismailis here and around the world. The array of facilities included is a reflection of the core values of the Ismaili community, its organization, its discipline, its social conscience, the importance of its community organizations, and its attitude towards the society in which it exists. In addition to the prayer hall, there are classrooms, meeting rooms, offices for the Arkan Development Network, a lecture and social hall, and exhibition spaces. I thank the government for its assistance in the development of this very special center as the permanent focus of the community's spiritual and social activities and a base for its continuing contribution to the life of the country. This is also an appropriate occasion to acknowledge and thank those who have made possible the actual construction of the center. Donors have been critical to the effort to give the Lisbon Ismaili Centre the profile that is appropriate to its location and mission. You should know of my warm gratitude and my admiration for your generosity, and that these thankful feelings are those of many around the world. This is an accomplishment for the entire community. I would like to express my gratitude and admiration to members of our own organization and community here in Portugal and my secretariat in France for the care and attention that they have given to this project spread over many long working days. I want to acknowledge, and forgive me if it's a member of my own family, the contributions of my brother, Prince Amin Aga Khan, whose taste and talent I salute and rely upon, for his special attention to design issues, tiles, fountains, soft and hard landscape. It is to the future that I would like to turn my attention. We live in a time of accelerating change, evidence of which surrounds us on a daily basis. Change can mean stimulation, opportunity, and hope. But it can also mean disorientation, dislocation and even conflict. Change can mean progress, but it can also mean that special efforts are required to improve access to the benefits of development for those less prepared to take advantage of them. These countervailing forces of change are of great interest to me because Ismailis have felt their full brunt over the course of their long history. But even more importantly, they're a matter of religious concern. Islam teaches Muslims to strive to achieve equilibrium between human existence and the absolute, and therefore attend to both spiritual and physical needs. As Imam of the Shia Ismaili Muslim, my responsibilities extend to both spiritual and material welfare of the Ismaili community. Although my faith and office place upon me a distinctive perspective and role, I am most certainly not alone in my concern about the pace and direction of change at this moment in history. In recognition of the critical problems of human welfare confronting today's world, and the role faiths can play in contributing to their resolution, Dr. George Carey, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and Mr. James D. Wolfenson, President of the World Bank, convened a dialogue on world faiths and development earlier this year. Leaders of 9 world faiths participated: the Baha'i, the Buddhist, Christian, Hindu, Jain, Jewish, Muslim, Sikh, and Tao. Within each, the major traditions were represented: the Christians by both the Catholic and Protestant leaders, the Muslims by leaders of Sunni and Shia communities. The dialogue took the form of an open and wide-ranging exchange of views among the participants. It concluded with a public commitment to continue the dialogue and to the development of specific follow-on activities. Several points emerged which are important and encouraging. I was particularly struck by the degree of commonality in the ethical basis that motivates and guides the development work of all the faiths. To find that similarity in Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, all of which share a common Abrahamic roots, was anticipated and comforting. But to discover the extent and strength of comparable formulations among the religions that have their origins further east was exhilarating for our common goals. The dialogue has now moved to the creation of working groups with membership drawn from both the World Bank and the faiths. They are charged with drawing lessons from successful projects addressing some of the most pressing problems of our time: food security, post-conflict resolution, delivery of social services, and the role of culture and cultural institutions for healthy societies. This process will work on faith organizations in different geographical settings and will seek to identify best practices. One goal is to lay the groundwork for cooperation between faith organizations and development organizations, including the World Bank. Another, and it is one to which I attach particular importance, is to explore the potential for cooperation between faith organizations in settings where interests are shared and the environment enabling. In this connection, I would like to compliment the government of Portugal on the law on religious freedom currently being discussed in the country. It is a pioneering and forward-looking undertaking that will encourage a new era of religious freedom. Respect and equality for over 60 different religious communities in the country, while maintaining the historic role of the Catholic Church. The draft law on religious freedom can serve as a model for the rest of the European community, where populations have grown more ethnically and religiously diverse in the past 3 to 4 decades. In a more immediate sense, I believe that the proposed law will provide a basis for greater cooperation between faith communities in Portugal, along the lines envisaged in the World Bank's interfaith dialogue. If experience is a guide elsewhere, we can expect the release of much energy and creativity. And the government and people of Portugal should be assured that the Ismaili Centre in Lisbon and all those it represents, the Ismaili community worldwide and the agencies of the Arkan Development Network, will devote their energies to making Portugal's leadership in this creative and uniquely exciting initiative the success it must be. Social harmony coupled with the freedom and respect of religious expression is a prerequisite for all human progress. Thank you.
Quero, antes de mais, agradecer-lhe, Alteza, as palavras tão amáveis que quis ter para com Portugal e os portugueses, que muito nos sensibilizam. Há 1 ano e meio reuníamos-nos neste local para uma cerimónia de particular significado para a comunidade ismaelita, para a cidade de Lisboa e para Portugal. O lançamento da primeira pedra deste magnífico centro que hoje inauguramos. Trata-se de um acontecimento que ilustra bem o notável trabalho que está a ser desenvolvido pela Fundação HK em Portugal, assim como o espírito abnegado e empreendedor da comunidade ismaelita e dos seus dirigentes. É de alimentar justiça que expressa aqui, Alteza, o sincero reconhecimento de Portugal e das autoridades portuguesas. Alteza, comemoramos este ano os 500 anos da viagem de Vasco da Gama. Celebramos a aventura marítima dos portugueses, o seu desejo de conhecer mais e mais experimentar o progresso científico que está na base das grandes transformações vividas pela humanidade. Mas celebramos, sobretudo, a solidariedade entre os povos, entre culturas. Celebramos, sobretudo, o respeito pela diferença, a paz e o progresso que desejamos ao alcance de todos, a confiança na capacidade do homem para construir sociedades mais justas e mais fraternas. O centro que hoje inauguramos constituirá um elemento importante em todo este contexto, um local de encontro entre civilizações e culturas, de diálogo enriquecedor, de debate sereno sobre as grandes questões que preocupam as sociedades modernas. Pela sua própria concepção e traça, este centro testemunhará o reencontro de duas heranças que moldaram a civilização peninsular do Oriente e do Ocidente, do Islão e da tradição judaico-cristã. Pela sua vocação inerente, o centro constituirá um espaço de diversidade, de pluralidade e de tolerância, que são a riqueza da nossa condição. Obrigado.
Thank you. behalf of the Portuguese Catholic University, I would like to say how much pleased we are today with the signature of this agreement, concluding a process of dialogue and mutual knowledge during the last years. This is the natural consequence of a common discovery of our universities. We are both confessional universities with a religious perspective of the world and life. So, we are both axiologically oriented institutions. We have both international dimension and perspectives, extended for more than one continent and country, from Asia until Europe, as in the case of the Aga Khan University, and from Europe to Asia, as in the case of the Portuguese Catholic University, and looking both for all the world.
Today marks a historic day as the Aga Khan University, or AKU, establishes its first intellectual relationship in Portugal with one of its premier centers of higher learning, the Portuguese Catholic University. The signing of this agreement in the presence of the Cardinal Patriarch and His Highness the Aga Khan, the Imam of the Ismaili Muslims, is significant as it is but one embodiment of the larger relationship in Portugal between the Catholic Church and the Ismaili Imamate. This collaboration between our universities is based on a collective commitment to go beyond common boundaries, to build bridges between diverse faiths and peoples by connecting different parts of the world together through the universal language of scholarship. The collaboration between our universities will cover disciplines such as culture, law, religion, ethics, the life sciences, education, as well as early childhood development. An initial area of common interest identified for cooperation is the comparative study of the impact of religion on the evolution of legal systems as it relates to the law of the land and the bearing on civil society. This specific program will be led from AKU side by our Institute for the Study of Muslim Civilizations in London, England. The Aga Khan University and the Portuguese Catholic University are building this relationship on our strong value systems and ethical frameworks that underpin our common goal of equitable human advancement. Through this partnership, we will collectively project Portugal's capabilities to contribute to capacity enhancement in countries of the developing world in Africa and Asia. This particular agreement is the beginning of a relationship between two universities that was started by faith organizations, but are secular universities and offer programs in many different disciplines. Our collaboration with the Portuguese Catholic University will result in a better understanding in looking at issues in the developing world of education, of malnutrition, of life sciences, of teacher education, of food development and looking at food production. All of these areas which are of concern of the world today are areas in which one of our two universities had some expertise, but by pooling our resources we will be able to look at real life problems and try and develop solutions for them.
Thank you. voice that in the mountain of virtues enchants the flowers and awakes the sound of animals. I am your warrior and your pacifist, your guardian and your servant, but have no swords or shields. I only have my music, with which I make a melody from your sweet words that becomes a prayer in my heart. You that give me strength, I ask you forever, walk with my inspiration.
The last 5 decades were fertile in changes in the worldwide context and society. The challenges presented at that time were often perceived as hindering the progress of the Jamaats. In all these challenges, Mawlana Hazar Imam's hand was beside us, pushing us further, giving us hope and confidence, and ensuring our safety. The Imam's leadership and guidance allowed the Jamaat and the institutions to increase their capacity and better face the challenges in a continuous evolving society. Khudavin has consistently brought new hope to many around the world, regardless of their faith or ethnicity, reminding us all of the invaluable meaning of human life as Allah's noblest creation, reminding the world that diversity is a singular human beauty. Khudavin, it is perhaps not a coincidence that the Golden Jubilee visit to Portugal has converged with the celebration just 2 days ago of the 10th inauguration anniversary of the Ismaili Centre, Lisbon, on 11th July. This magnificent gift that Mawlana Hazar Imam bestowed upon the Portuguese jurisdiction and the worldwide Jamaat has brought immense benefits and joy. visitors often refer to the magnificence of the Ismaili Center's architecture, ambience, and facilities, identifying it as a place of harmony, of cultural encounters and reflection. When they commend the building for its service and contribution to the construction of a pluralistic society, we think it was the vision and generosity of our beloved Imam. For all your guidance and direction, Khudavin, we say shukrana, thank you, merci, gracias, obrigado. But we remain aware that no words can ever express the immensity of our gratitude for Imam's benevolence. To mark this very special occasion of the Golden Jubilee Jamati Institutional Dinner, Hazar Imam, we seek permission to submit a small memento as a token of the Portuguese jurisdiction Jamati institutions, loyalty and gratitude for Khudavin's benevolence and guidance. Mawlana Hazar Imam, this memento consists of a silver filigree piece depicting a 16th century caravel, period considered as the zenith of the Portuguese discoveries and for many believed to have been the beginning of globalization. Now that physical roots are already discovered, we hope that this humble gift can symbolize the Imam's endeavors to the establishment of new pathways of connection and dialogue within mankind.
I'd like to tell you how immensely happy I am to have been here tonight and to have celebrated with you this Jubilee visit to Portugal. Since some time, Portugal has been a country in which the Jamaat and its institutions and the Imamate have been experimenting with new initiatives to see whether it would be possible in the Western world, in a strongly Catholic country, to establish new initiatives which would bring together people of Christian backgrounds and Muslim backgrounds to work together to try to solve some of the issues that are ahead of us. And we are trying something which has never been tried before. And for an institution of faith to enter into a formal diplomatic relationship is extremely important in the sense that that agreement has to function within the faiths of both communities. Therefore, the objectives need to be compatible with the objectives of this society and of the Imamate of the Jamaat. And I want to take this occasion this evening to compliment you for the magnificent preparation for this Jubilee visit, for the wonderful way in which the center presents itself after some 10 years of life. It has been a most happy visit. And I hope that the Jamaat and the leaders realize that for me it's very important to see happiness in the Jamaat, to see young people who feel at ease. Because one of the things that has most often been said to me here in Portugal is the quality of our leadership. And I wanted you to know that because the leaders are assembled here. And the image that you have given of the Jamaat is noted outside the Jamaat. And that creates a sense of trust and confidence. People come together around competence, around ability, around knowledge. They don't like mediocrity. I hope that it'll be a wonderful evening, a happy evening, and congratulations. Mubarak. Thank you.
Thank you. practical terms was that we're going to support 300 schools at the national level. According to the request of the schools in the area, they're going to buy books for the reading, which suit according to the Portuguese policy of the education services.
We are very much committed to improve the literacy standards of Portuguese children. Well, we have had a problem with these standards, and so we would like to involve different partners from the civil society, and the Aga Khan network has been working with some educational projects that we find very interesting. And so for us it's very important to have the Aga Khan network on board.